Hi everyone, just headed out to the garden this morning to get some wildflower seed planted. Now typically here in Southern California, I lay down my wildflower seed in November and December because we do have such mild winters, and that way, as soon as the weather warms up in the spring, they sprout and have a beautiful blanket of color. And it also helps with weed control in my garden. But as you know, we've had a ton of rain here in Southern California. I didn't want my seeds just to get washed down my hill. But today, we've got a sunny day, so I'm gonna give it a go. I'm gonna show you where I'm gonna plant them and what seeds I'm using. Well, just to give you the big picture, I'm going to be planting my wildflower seed behind that white wire fencing that you see. I did plant some wildflowers here last summer, but before I installed the fencing, they all just kind of fell down the hill. And then I tried to redo it while they were still growing with the fencing, but it just didn't work out too well. So hoping to start over from scratch this year. And there are some wildflower flowers kind of popping up, but you can see, especially with all the rain we've had, there's a ton of weeds. And I'm hoping that by getting some new seeds laid down and planted, it will help keep these weeds at bay. Now in the past, I have just used seeds that you buy at the big box store, like the big packages of wildflower seeds, but haven't been super happy with the quality. There's a lot of filler in them, and you get a lot of flowers like this here, which are pretty, but I really want to see more of a blanket of color. So I'm going with In My Gardener's Pollinator and Save the Bees Wildflower Seed Kit, and you guys know he has super high quality seeds. Of course, no fillers or anything like that. It's a beautiful mix of annuals and perennials, and also a lot of edible flowers, which is a huge plus. And these are going to attract bees and hummingbirds and all kinds of pollinators to my garden, which I'm super excited about. We can all use more of the pollinators. Of course, has sunflowers, which are one of my very favorite flowers. So I'm really looking forward to getting these planted, and that way they'll pop up with our rains that are still coming, and I'll have some really pretty flowers the very first part of spring. What I'm going to do first to give my wildflower seeds as little as possible to compete with is to clear this whole area out, get rid of the old, and make room for the new. Well, these are some pretty nasty looking weeds up here. I'm trying to get them out by the roots as much as I can. Ugh, come on, come on. Ah, oh, there we go. Ugh, it's pretty mucky under here. Well, that ended up being a bit more of a job than I thought, because some of those weeds were really stubborn. You can see that big pile behind me. But now what I'm gonna do is just loosen up the soil using my pitchfork before I add some compost and organic fertilizer. Well, I've got my wildflower seed bed I'll loosen up with my pitchfork. I went over with my hand rake to get any little bits of leaves and weeds out. Now I'm going to amend it with some of my own black gold. Beautiful compost that will help feed my garden the nutrients it needs. I'm also going to sprinkle in some of the Vermisteria worm castings and some of my favorite organic fertilizer and my gardener's Trifecta Plus. And this will all help my wildflower seed bed get off to a really good start. And I'm just going to rake it into the soil. Now that I've got my garden bed amended, it's time for my favorite part, planting the seeds. Now, it's super, super easy to plant wildflower seeds. What I've done is just combine some of the contents of the seed packet in a little jar, so I get a nice mix, a really beautiful, colorful wildflower blanket. So easy to do. Let me show you how I like to do it. Now, what I like to do is just pour the seeds into my hand. And then just broadcast them lightly over the surface of the soil. Then I'm just going to very lightly rake them in. Now I took out my drip irrigation hose in order to plant, so I'm just going to lay that back down. I'm going to cover it up lightly with some shredded leaf mulch so the birds don't get the seeds, and so the rain doesn't wash it away. Be sure to head over to my website, CaliKimGardenAndHome.com. you want to read my blog post. There's a lot of great information there. And also download a free copy of my growing guide, Grow 3 Vegetables in 6 Weeks, for some quick tips for your spring planting. Well, that's pretty much all there is to planting wildflower seed. Super quick, super simple, super inexpensive, will help control the weeds here on my hill, and I cannot wait to see a beautiful blanket of wildflowers. I'll put links to all the supplies I use in this video down in the video description, so you can check that out if you're interested. And comment below, let me know if you're growing wildflowers in your garden and what you're excited about planting for spring. Thank you so much for watching. We'll see you on the next video.